Hello, my name is Dr. Joseph Blattman, an assistant professor in the School of Life Sciences.
I'm Dr. Samira Kiani, assistant professor in the School of Biological and Health Systems Engineering.
Today we're going to demonstrate a few examples of proper procedures to avoid accidental needle sticks.
A stick may seem like a minor incident, but when the needle contains a virus or pathogen, it can have serious consequences.
If you see someone in the laboratory not wearing the correct personal protective equipment, or not using the right safety equipment, or doing a procedure incorrectly, you should tell them to stop. When working with hazardous materials, do not use needles unless absolutely necessary. Use every precaution to reduce the risk of an accident. So when working with needles, you should wear the proper personal protective equipment. This includes gloves, a lab coat, and proper eye protection. You may also want to consider additional protective equipment, including puncture-resistant gloves.
You can see that this scientist is doing this exactly right. She is using a holder to extract a virus from a plastic centrifuge tube. This is very important because if she were to hold the plastic tube in her hands, the needle could go through both sides or slip off the side. Another option is to use a tube rack placed against a wall or column for stability. This is important because she is now using two hands to hold the needle when the tube is secured. This keeps both hands on the opposite end of the needle.
Never recap needles. The most common incident for needle sticks involves recapping needles after use. Always dispose of needles in proper sharps containers. Sometimes researchers think they are doing something the right way, but they can be wrong. Here are a few tips approved by the Arizona State University Institutional Biosafety Committee.
As a researcher, you may get pressed for time. That isn't an excuse to get careless and rush through your work. Shortcuts lead to injury, especially when handling needles. Always plan ahead. The extra time prevents you from rushing through your work.
Even though you have performed injections multiple times, the likelihood of getting stuck with a needle increases. Repetitive work can put you in an autopilot mindset, making you less likely to consider preventative measures. Take 20 to 30 second breaks between injections. This allows you to refocus on your work performance.
Some of you may think this will never happen to you. Having this mindset leads to carelessness, which leads to injuries. Protect yourself from self-inflicted needle sticks by using the proper equipment and adhering to proper work procedures.
If you do happen to get stuck by a needle, report the incident immediately to your supervisor. Seek immediate medical attention and notify ASU Environmental Health and Safety.
If you have questions about risks and hazards associated with the research and preventative measures, discuss them with your principal investigator and lab supervisor or email EHNS. For additional trainings, visit this website.